Hi guys, how are you? Hey, I got my Instagram people, I got my Facebook people, I got a combined audience today. You see I'm a little bundled up here, it's a little cold inside my place of business, so I'm trying to let it heat up a little bit, but I want to talk to you all about, well, let me tell my Instagram people. This is Knowledge by Nikki Smith, that's Nikki with 1K. So knowledgebynikki.com is where you'll find most of the things that I have going on. I'm steady adding stuff. We're going to have it all the way live on December 4th. You'll be able to find everything that I do. But I want to talk to you all a little bit today about how do you view your customers? Now, this is for my salon owners. But those of you all that may not be salon owners, you can kind of take a little test on this too. I don't know if you all realize, but most of your clients, for those salon owners and people that are still standing behind a chair, most of your clients are a lot like you. They just really are. Most of your clients, if you really did a realistic and honest survey of at least 75% of them, most of them look like you. 90% of them sometimes look like you. So what does that mean to a stylist that's trying to evolve, to a booth renter that's trying to evolve, to a commission worker that's trying to evolve? This is what I want you to understand. I have been in this industry now for almost 30 years and I have seen it all. I now have a group of stylists and mostly salon owners that are calling me, texting me, emailing me, messaging me. You know, we got all these different communication vehicles today about how do they make the shift. How do they shift the gift, basically? How do we do this? How do we shift this gift? How do we not just do the same thing over and over? And this really is for a lot of people that have been in this industry a long time. I've been in it 30 years now. It'll actually be 30 February 28th. And this really can more so apply to people, I would say, that have at least 10 years or more in this industry. How do you shift the gift? Well, the first thing I can tell you, now this is marketing 101 here. The way to shift the gift is the first thing you have to do is you have to look at what you have. You have to look at who's sitting in your chair, who is the type of person that likes to have conversation with you. And because you do know, it's not just about how well you do hair. For both my audiences here, it's not just about that. There are thousands of stylists, non-stylists, YouTubers, sitting at home stylists, ain't never seen a school stylist, that can run circles around some of us that actually have licenses. So it's not just about technique. It's about what a client feels when they get out your chair or the connection that you all make. Matter of fact, my Instagram followers, you all aren't accustomed to watching me, so I give my Facebook people a lot of books to read. There's a book I want both audiences to get. It's by John C. Maxwell. It's called Everyone Communicates, But Few Connect. Remember that. Everyone Communicates, But Few Connect. It's a really good book. It's by John C. Maxwell. So connection. So I want everybody to first understand, before you start analyzing what you have, you have to first look at who are the people, who are the groups, who connects with me. And I'm talking about natural. I'm not talking about putting on airs and talking about creating this facade of professionalism and you know you're not really professional. I'm talking about the people who naturally get in your chair and stay. What does that group look like? Because your marketing and how you make the shift has to first start there. Okay, I'll give you the example of me. When I first started trying to figure out, this is about my 15th year in the industry, and I was getting kind of tired of burning candles at both ends. I've always been a morning person. So I get here to the salon super early, 5, 6, 7 o'clock in the morning. And I was always the last one to leave. So I'm leaving at after midnight sometimes. Okay. So this is what I had to figure out. When I got tired of doing that, I said, God, I love what I do, but I cannot continue to work this way. This will not work. I needed some type of marketing strategy. Somebody needed to help me do something to figure out how to take where I am and risk as little as possible, because you are going to take some risk, and be able to evolve into whatever this next phase looks like. So the first thing I was told to do, because I took classes, I don't have a problem reaching out to people, help me figure this out. I took classes. I said, okay, let me look at the clients I have, not just how many, but let me look at the type of clients that I had. I realized that I had a lot of middle to upper class women. That's what I had. Middle to upper class women. And I'm talking about modestly middle, to, not like not rich, but doing okay. I had those type of women. Most of them had management, supervisor, or administrative type of jobs. Most of them were in charge, wherever they were, whatever field they were in, whether it was nursing, whether it was the educational system, I don't care what it was. If they worked at the bus company, they were the boss. When I sat down and I figured out the type of people that I actually had in my business, then I had to research what is it that those people like. And lo and behold, what was amazing about it, what was also an eye-opener for me, is that 90%, really, more than 75%, but 90% of my clients were like me. They were stable. They didn't bounce around everywhere. They were people that had focused vision. And you can go on and on and on. You all see what I'm talking about. Your clients, good or bad, will look and resemble you. They really will. Now, I'm not saying that if we don't like what we see, I'm not saying that we can't change that. But what I'm saying is we have to start from what comes natural. Meaning I had accumulated this type of client without trying. It just happened to be that way because these were the people that naturally connected with me. Natural. So what I started doing, I started saying, okay, I need to evolve. I need to figure out how to take this group that looks like me, think how I think, learn about some of the things that they like, some of the things that they're into, some of the things that promotes loyalty with them. So I had the kind of, I call it she, she, poo, poo client. Okay, that means this is the client that appreciates coffee and donuts and wine and cheese, and they don't like having to park down the street. So I even, when I opened my first salon, I made sure I even had spaces that were close enough to the building that was designated for my business that my clients didn't have to walk. I didn't have the type of clients that were going to walk. If they had to walk too far, they were going to complain every time they came into the salon about how they had to walk. So I also start learning about different types of marketing platforms that they were in, which by all of them being leaders or having the right to make decisions, I said, you know what? I'm going to put these jokers to work for me. I start coming up with platforms because they're always telling other people what to do, where they receive discounts and benefits from them shifting or from them advertising me heavily to other people, because they were in the position to do so, okay? I started coming up with hundreds over the years of marketing platforms. I can't give them all to you today, but I started coming up with these platforms that basically started using what I had and evolving my business into places I wanted to go. Okay, that's just my example. So let's say you have a different type of client. Let's say your client is younger. Let's say your client is more of the fly-by-nighters, more of the, I don't know, you could just, that young people, 20s, 30s, even some teens, some of them don't have the life stability where they're able to be able to promote that type of business. So there are different marketing approaches that you have to take with them. You're going to be more like what I call Walmart, which is fine because Walmart is a billion-dollar company. You're going to probably have more turnover, but you'll have more, you'll be able to take more walk-ins. You could do things that get them to promote mass people coming, meaning that a teenager or someone young, if they're social, they may literally be able to, you'll say, you know what, for every 10 people you send me, this is what I'm going to do for you, because you know they promote in masses. Now, you'll have to take those 10 and do the same thing. Because unfortunately, if that's your group, if that's what you attract, there are some realities that come with that group that they just don't stick around all the time. They just don't. You saw, it's the Walmart concept. It's the volume concept. It's the thing that I'm just going to keep the volume. Okay, this is just where you start. I'm not saying this is where you stay. This is where you start. So you have to first sit down and say, let me assess. And for those of you all that are watching that may not have done this, what I want you to do is get yourself some type of application. Really simple. You know, everything is done online now, but I want you to print this out. And I want you to get something and get all of your clients' information. What are your interests? What are your hobbies? It would almost be like something you would get if you went to a spa. I want you to have your clients start figuring this out if you can't figure it out. Start getting them to list their hobbies, their job occupations. You will start to see a common denominator with the type of people that you connect with. You'll see it. I don't care who you are, what you do. You will start to see a common denominator between what all of them do, even what all of them talk about, even some of their interests. When you figure that out, you'll also have to be honest with yourself, good or bad, that these are the people that you naturally connect with, and so your marketing platform has to start there, so then you can evolve into other things. And you can utilize that group to also help you evolve. I'll take the example I gave you earlier. We talked about if you have a fly-by-night clientele, they don't spend a lot of money, but you'll have a whole group of them coming regularly. Maybe not the same ones, but a constant flow. If you want to evolve and you want to start saying, look, I need clients that are a little more loyal. I need clients that I can retain a little bit more. So let me start utilizing them and saying, look, if you can get someone, you can put an age limit on it if you want to. For everyone you recommend me that's over age this, that stays on a regular schedule with me for at least 6 months, I will give you X, Y, Z. You will even get that young person that just flies, they come in whenever they're going somewhere, they're not regular every week, every other week. You will get them to seek out, they know what stable people look like. They know, get their mom to come there, get their grandma, get their aunt, whoever. They will get those people to come, and those people will stay on your roster for 6 months or more, and as long as you take care of them, then now you're starting to evolve into a different group. You'll start seeing how your evolution, using what you have first, recognizing what it needs to be inspired. There is the same stimuluses are not the same from person to person. Their socioeconomic class changes, their things that their interest changes what stimulates them. You may have a bunch of introverts, you may have a bunch of extroverts. You have to really do a real analyzation, almost like Google Analytics if you want to. And you need to come up with a measuring system. A metric is what they call it. Something that measures how what you're doing is working. So you know when you need to change it. But this is something you have to do research. You may have to pay someone a couple dollars to help you figure out how to do this, to help you establish structured programs that you can measure what's happening. When you put a discount program out, or when you put a new client program out, you need to have a measuring system of knowing how many did that reach. Okay, this is not something, if you don't know how to do this, you may have to pay someone a couple dollars to help you do this. I also help people do this. You need to figure it out. You need to say, okay, I got this group. I'm going to put this group to work. This group, what are they going to bring me? And what is that group going to bring me? So you have to be able to track whether you do it manually or you do it on a computer. But you first have to realize you're attracting your own kind, and you have to work there first. For all of my salon owners that are watching this, that are constantly trying to figure out, how do I get from behind this chair? How do I do this? This is where it starts. You have to start. Don't just jump into something that you know nothing about. You have no idea. Now you can learn about stuff. Before you start launching or putting your net out there, at least learn about the new waters that you're going into. But meantime, between time, you can be doing exactly what I'm talking about. Analyze what you have, start using that to market to get what you need from it, because you're naturally attracting this group. And then if you feel you need to shift and attract a different kind of group, then you start utilizing them, coming up with new marketing strategies to appeal to that group. This is just simple marketing, but it requires this. You got to think. You got to think. You may have to get some people to help you. This is something some of you all that are on Instagram may or may not know. I'm doing a Salon Owners Conference late next year, November 4th and 5th. These are the type of things we're going to deal with. We're going to deal with the type of marketing and branding and what we call shifting the gift. We're going to deal with these type of things that are going to help you start where you are and then go to the next level. You know, I'm all for taking risks, jumping out there. That's fine because I've done it, but I've also done the research. So even when we give you an assignment, and I'm going to give you more information about the conference in a minute. Even when we give you an assignment at this conference, it's going to require some preparation before you just jump out there. But we're going to give you an immediate assignment. You do this for 1 year, for 6 months, for 3 months, 1 month. This is what you do. Then at that 6 month marker, you're going to shift and you're going to start now using that group to build the next cycle. Then you're going to use that group to build the next cycle. But I wanted to bring this to you all because I get so many people that want to abort what they're doing right now, as if we're even in a position to do that, and just jump into some other stuff. That's not how life works. No one that has ever been successful can tell you or will tell you that their success did not come with them taking this and a piece off of that, and then that, then going to something else, then taking a piece off of that and going to something else. Even if they eventually ended up doing something that had nothing to do with what they started, it still was something from that thing that spearheaded the next thing. So they had to start. You have to start with where your money is. You have to start with the amount. I don't care if you don't have but five people. You can make those five work for you. All right? Salon owners, we had a Facebook Live earlier this week, last week, about delegating. This is also, if you're a person where you just have people that love to be around, you love to sit around, you love to just leech off you with information and just want to just say, look, help me do this, put them to work to help you get to the next level. But you, if this is the people you're attracting, if you attract clients that are like that, they just love serving you. They're like, look, what do you want me to do? These are the clients that get up and they sweep the hair up for you in your shop. They'll take your garbage out. These are the, if you have people that have a gift and love for service, then that is your group. Use that group to try to help serve you better so that you can now go into the next group. But you got to start where you are. You got to start where you are. Look at what you got. Say, look, okay, my money says this, and I got these kind of people, and I need to do this over here. So how am I going to draw the line from here to there? How am I going to do that? You cannot do it alone. You have to have people that help you do this. It is absolutely necessary. But I want to challenge you all first to being able to do the homework and do the project of figuring out where you are first. Figure that out. And then we can help you get to the next level. So, if you all are interested in this conference, now I will say this conference is for salon owners. That's my group. I already told you, I've always been the one that connected with the leaders, the people that are in charge. That's been who I am since I was little. When I was 10 years old, my friends were 17. People that were always slightly ahead of where I'm trying to go. So that's my group. So those of you that are salon owners, I'm sorry, but this is geared up and I will check. This is geared up to salon owners. That is what it's geared up for. It's geared up for the people that have already jumped, and now they're like, oh my God, I jumped in this water, and now I need a lifeline. I need somebody to help me figure out where to go and what to do. And it's for that group, guys. It is November 4th and 5th. It is in Chicago, 2018, next year. It is at the Chicago Midway Airport. Your hotel is included. Your breakfast is included. Your lunch is included. If you all are interested in more information, you can text me, hear me, text me at 708-798-7900. If there's anybody who regularly listens to me, please put that up on the screen for me. 708-798-7900. This is the number that you can reach me, and I respond very quickly to if you're interested in the conference. That's all you got to say is I want some info on the conference. Everything will be online full blast by December 4th. We're a little behind. I got so much to put online, all right? But the goal is for all my salon owners that are still standing behind the chair, that's what this talk today is about. If you are still standing behind the chair and you are trying to figure out how to shift, I need you to first start where you are. I need you to first look at what you have. Look at the amount, the people that work for you. Look at the clients that you have because you're still behind the chair. I need you to start first working with what you have. You have to be honest about what you have also. You have to say, you know what? I got these fly-by-nighters. They don't stay. I'm not doing good client retention. So the first thing I'm going to do is think volume. If you have those type of people, I get it. But you're going to have to think volume. You're going to have to think like Walmart. Walmart doesn't make their money necessarily off of somebody always buying from Walmart. But they have so many people coming through there on a regular basis, even different people, that they still been able to become the most successful retailer in the world. This is what you have to do. Once you do that, you'll at least, now let me tell you what the flip side of that is though. If you get your retail center set up real good, let me tell you the disadvantage for people like me. I have crazy retail, but because I have such loyal customers, it's the same people over and over and over again. So they've already bought everything. So there's nobody else new to buy stuff. You actually can make crazy money in retail dollars because you'll always have this new batch of people coming through there. Yeah, they may not stay in your chair. Hopefully you get to that point where maybe you have a balance of both, but you will have people you can constantly retail to. And people that don't come regularly got to buy shampoo, they got to buy conditioner, they got to buy flat irons, they got to buy this. They have to buy a lot of stuff because they're not salon people. Your retail dollars can be stupid if this is you. That's another analyzation. We'll help you with that. Fine. If you got a bunch of different people that come through all the time, your retail should be lined up across the whole. You should have 30% of your space dedicated to retail at the least. 30%. If this is you, you need to start carving out some walls. You need to start, as IKEA says, think cubic. Start making stuff go this way instead of that way so you can utilize your space well. Whatever your position, wherever you are right now in your business, you can evolve, but you first got to start where you are. All right? So come see me. Salon Owners Conference, we're going to have a great time. I've made it very affordable. You get airport, shuttle, hotel, everything but dinner. You just got to be there. And more information than what the cost is really encompasses. I realized somebody told me I had about 5 people sign up. They were like, is that all? So I've made it very affordable. I also have payment plans. You got almost a whole year to pay. So 708-798-7900. You all come see me. And I want you all, what I decided to do, praise God, I've gotten such a large following now with the Facebook Live that I'm going to start a Facebook page that is just going to be called Nikki Smith Live. Some of you all have told me, look, girl, I can't accept no more friends on either one of my Facebook pages, and I don't have time to go through and delete people. I don't have time to do that. So I'm going to start another Facebook page. I'll be sure to tell you all when it's launched. Nikki Smith Live. All we're doing is videos. That's it. Videos. If we got conferences, you'll be able to link directly from there to the website. My website is Knowledge by Nikki with 1K, NIKI.com. And you can log on there after December. I got all my classes already there where I'm going to be. But you'll be able to see the flyers. You'll be able to get some question answers. You'll be able to find out, okay, I need to learn how this marketing thing goes. Honestly, what I'm telling you, it's not really exclusive to this industry. When I go to business seminars, they aren't just talking about the beauty industry. They're talking about just business, period. Any business that needs to evolve has to first figure out where it is. You have to first figure out where you are. When you look at things like Shark Tank, The Prophet, these things, The Prophet especially, when he comes in and he tries to save these businesses, he doesn't go into revamping the whole business. He said, look, where are you right now? Like a lady was on it the other day. She makes pies. He's okay, how many pies you making? How many this? How many that? He starts from where you are. He also understands your personality. He also understands the type of people you attract. He starts from where you are and just says, okay, we're not going to push the envelope too much, but we're just going to get you to do a little bit more over here so we can start getting you into the habit and of focusing slightly in a different direction. But we got to start here first. All right, guys? So it is 8:23. I'm going to check out a little bit earlier today. I start work. I only work in the salon Thursday and Friday, so I'll be here doing my clients. I like to be early. I've been here for an hour now, but I like to have about a half hour of just breathing time because I got the type of clients I have to keep my door locked. They'll be beating on the door at 1:45, and I just tell them, give me a minute. Just give me a minute because they'll be here. That's another thing. I have clients that like to come early. So guess what I did at one part in my life? I said, okay, and I didn't even tell them. For everybody that comes early for their appointment, I gave them a gift. For those of you all that got clients that don't like being on time, that's what you do. You don't tell them no. You surprise them. Girl, you 15 minutes early. I got a gift for you. They'll be 15 minutes early every time they come get their hair done. They really will. Because they're like, oh my God, when I get there early, it could be something simple. You know, you listen to them all the time. I'm really big on making gifts and things that clients appreciate specific to them. For instance, if I have a client that I know drinks Pepsi like water, then what I would do for her is if she was early, I may have it stored somewhere because I can give it to clients if she doesn't come. I'd give her a case of Pepsi. That would not only incentivize her, but it would also let her know I thought of you. I thought of you when I did this. So you might have to keep a little stash of some of the stuff your clients like. I have clients that tell me they like all kind of stuff. Some of them like, you know, we eat a lot of jerk chicken, Jamaican food in Chicago. We got jerk places everywhere. So I have certain clients that love jerk. So I do stuff like get them a bottle of jerk sauce. That's only costing me $3. But you get this if they come in early. They say, oh my God, they'd be, matter of fact, they'd probably be too early. But you see what I'm saying? You just take where you are, guys. We can always shift. We can shift the gift. But we have to figure out first where we are before we can figure out where we're going. I'm going to leave you with this. John Maxwell, as you all know that listen to me, one of my most favorite authors in the world, always says, you cannot achieve what you have not defined. That's what he says in a lot of his book. Meaning you got to define that. You got to figure that thing out first. Then you can achieve something else. Because a lot of us are just running, doing a whole bunch of stuff. And we're not getting anywhere. Time is out for that. And for those of you all that are watching me, been in this business 10, 20, 30 years, y'all know what I'm talking about. That gets old. That gets played out. You get tired. Look, I got the younger people encouraging me to get better in this digital platform. So once I got it, I'm all in now. Mimi Hawkins, my girl, I love her. She's on here. She's the one who set up Zoom for me. Mimi, my webinars will be starting soon. God bless you. Thank you. She said, you need to get on Zoom. You need to do this. That's Mimi Hawkins there. You need Mimi, I'm in. I got everything set up. I'll have some live, some pre-recorded. So I'm in. Zoom, they got me together, explained to me how it's all supposed to go. So I'm ready, y'all, because it's time for me to go to the next level. But guess what I did? I took the people inside my business and outside my business that are in leadership positions, the people that I connect with, and I said, can you help me? They get it because they themselves are trying to evolve. So leaders, especially giving leaders, are always trying to share information. She shared that information with me. It's going to change the game for me, guys. I'm about to start doing webinars. That means I don't have to get on a plane every time I do something. I love y'all, but I'm tired of sleeping in somebody else's bed all the time. All right? But look, guys, seriously, I got to go. Peace out. Salon Owners Conference. Text me if you're interested. 708-798-7900. We're going to have a blast. And tickets are selling quick, and we aren't even in January 1. So I got really affordable payment plans. If you want to get in on it early, I got great speakers, like really, really good speakers. Look, I'm going to be learning. I'm going to be sitting back. I teach a couple classes. I'm going to be sitting back learning. Okay? Because you can always apply those principles to whatever stage in life you are. But I got to go. Peace out. Knowledge by Nikki with 1K. This is Nikki Smith. I'll see you next week. 8:00 to 8:50. I actually be in LA, but I'll just get up. I got to remember because I'll be that specific time. 8:00 standard. 8:00. Where am I? Central. 8:00 Central Time, which is 6 a.m. Is that right? 6 a.m. California time. That's fine. I get up at 6 a.m. Not a problem. I'll see you then. Peace out.